Penguin Random House Audio presents Stacked, Your Super Serious Guide to Modern Money Management by Joe Saul-Sehy and Emily Guy Birken. Read for you by Joe Saul-Sehy with Emily Guy Birken and Julie Ray Harrison. This is the author, Joe Saul-Sehy. For Cheryl, remember all those times I messed up with money and told you it'd someday pay off? Hashtag mic drop.
Damn it. I was going to dedicate this to Cheryl, too. All right, I guess this is for Jamie. Thanks for always laughing at my jokes. Except the puns, of course.
Introduction, wherein I explain why us and why this book. In this time of health and financial uncertainty, there are two things I wish I'd known earlier. One, start with the basics. Back when I struggled with money, I was always searching for shortcuts, easy fixes, and ways to cover up mistakes that I'd made along the way. And I've made more than my fair share. A better path, and the only one I know now that works after too much stumbling around, is to focus on building your house one brick at a time, just like the pig in that timeless tale. Plus, and this isn't in the book, it isn't the complex stuff that we mess up. It's the basics. My entire career, I've been surrounded by broke professors, people who know everything about money, but who implement nothing. There's a serious problem in the USA. According to a report from research group Nonfiction, over 150 million people reported that they've cried about their money. I don't think they cried about central bank digital currency or complex Roth IRA strategies. I'll bet my nearly 30 years in finance that they were crying because there was a disconnect between what they wanted from life and where their money was going. That's why we start with the basics. It's also why my second point's so important. Laughter is more important than ever. If I hadn't had the ability to laugh through my mistakes, I wouldn't be here to roll out the red carpet for you right now. If you're going to grow, mistakes are going to happen. Your goal should be to make those mistakes quickly and work past them. The ability to shake your head, stand back up, laugh a little, and keep moving will allow you to stay positive and focused on the prize. So, with those two universal truths in mind, it's become clear to me that there's a big need for a financial book that can make you laugh as you listen. Sure, countless financial books already hit store shelves year after year. My co-writer Emily, the brains of this operation and a former bookseller, wants me to clarify that I understand that financial books, like all other books, are placed lovingly on store shelves by professional English majors who understand the importance of the printed word, and they do not go about throwing them willy-nilly at shelves like they're flying salmon at Pike Place Fish Market. She also points out that the number of financial books released every year is in fact countable, and that my description of them as countless shows laziness in my math. My point, already nearly derailed, is that there are lots of financial books out there. But in good times or bad, something important is missing from the genre. I know about this gap because nearly every author of the top titles each year asks to come talk about it on my podcast. In the course of creating and co-hosting the Stacking Benjamins podcast, I construct 3 shows per week, 47 weeks of the year. With that many shows to record, I ask a number of experts to sidle on up to the microphone. The majority of the world's top personal finance guests have ducked their heads and climbed down the stairs to my mom's basement to discuss their latest project. You'll hear mom later because she owns our podcasting headquarters and has plenty of wisdom to share. In our corner of the world, finance and investing are serious sports. The prevailing attitude among many in my cohort seems to be, money only works if you take it seriously. There are important retirement accounts to fill and overly serious bank managers with somber mustaches and knowing gazes awaiting your next savings deposit. There's no room for giddiness in wealth building. Unfortunately, treating money as only slightly less fun than a colonoscopy limits the reach of our collective voices. We are pigeonholed with people promising wealth without work and riches beyond measure, and often for a much stiffer and hidden price than a free podcast. Enter Stacked. The truth is, the sport of Benjamin stacking isn't played the way you may think. As it turns out, being a big shot and being wealthy are two totally different games. We're going to teach you the real game we had to stumble into, and happily for all of us, the real game is more unicorns and rainbows and less spreadsheets and deprivation.
Hey, it's Emily. Overpromising? Just a bit?
Maybe. But if you've ever wondered, could I stack some Benjamins? Then you've come to the right book. Whether you're intimidated by money terms or can quote every line from The Big Short, you're sure to find something helpful in this handbook. But don't just take my word for it. Emily Guy Birken has helped countless readers build their own stacks into intimidating towers, and she's agreed to help. If you've listened to the podcast, you'll know that we promise to teach you nothing. But I don't want to tarnish Emily's reputation, so it's high time to do something useful for once and make this book a fresh start, something you can actually learn from. We have no clue how far along the journey you've come, so we're going to begin where any good journey should, at the beginning. Our goal here is to stack that first Benjamin, which frankly, any supervillain will tell you is the hardest part of world domination. The first section of this book is titled, well, Stacking Your First Benjamin. And these chapters focus on the strategies my friends and I use to build our financial foundation. We'll help you set up a budget and figure out how to save for the things you care about most. You'll learn how to increase your income and nix any money drains that keep your dreams from coming true. We'll also demystify the weirdness that is debt and credit so it's easier to reach your goal of a college education, early retirement, or maybe that volcano lair you've had your eye on. The second section is called Building a Stack of Benjamins. And now that we've filled the backpack with the basics, we'll embark on the great journey of investing. Why invest? Because if you don't, you're going to need to save nearly dollar for dollar the same amount you'll want to spend in later years. If you're living a $50,000 lifestyle and planning for a 20-year-long retirement, you're looking at saving $1 million. Sure, you might be able to do that, but what if we taught you how to let interest do the work for you? Let's all jump on the lazy train. Less work for you and more work for your money. That's a big key to success. From there, we'll teach you how to protect your money and potential income in the holding on to Benjamin section. That means we're going to focus on something we money nerds call risk management, which you might know by its more dreaded name of insurance. You may need insurance, but starting off with such a loaded word is like walking up to the high school bully and asking him for a wedgie. Talking about insurance may be a necessary mental wedgie, but the interesting part comes from discussing how it can skew the odds in our favor. In short, we use insurance to mitigate the risks of life, kind of like real-world cheat codes. That way, a broken dishwasher can't derail our plan to conquer the world. Finally, we'll wrap up this whole package with the sexy stuff everybody wants to talk about in a section we call Stacking Benjamins on Top of Your Other Benjamins. We'll wind through tall but true tales about advanced-level investing, mitigating the effects of those shuffling hordes known as inflation and taxes, and hiring a financial advisor. We'll share examples from some of the best investors we know. We're confident that you'll be such a money nerd by the time you end this audiobook, you'll leave with a tear in your eye. You're welcome. Now, go join us in chapter one already. A richer, funnier, and infinitely Benjaminier life awaits you.
Part 1, Stacking Your First Benjamin. The world is full of obvious things which nobody by any chance ever observes. Sherlock Holmes.
Chapter 1, One Magical Idea to Rule Them All. Tools you'll need: paper, pen, some degree of imagination. Don't worry, it's not so much Walt Disney as, that cloud looks like Uncle Tony. Virtually every financial book starts with the same tired move, asking you to write out your goals. Well, there's nothing wrong with that strategy for financial planning. Seeing it over and over starts to feel like hearing the same old pickup lines. Hey, baby, are those some well-thought-out financial goals in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me? Is it hot in here, or is it just your 30-year financial plan? I like your money goals. They'd look great in a pile on my bedroom floor. Here's the problem with goal setting. Many people mess up their plans from the beginning. They ask the wrong questions, and that makes the whole process far more difficult than it needs to be. Back when I was a financial planner, it felt like everyone...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.